So as you can see, we have now isolated the area. We have our W3 clamp as a retentive clamp on the second molar. We have isolated the first molar, the second premolar, the first premolar, and the canine. At this point, all we need is to secure our rubber dam on the mesial aspect. And the best way to do that, and the easiest way, is by using these wedjets. I cut them approximately, you can see these are maybe 10 millimeters long. I have them pre-cut in my office. And all you have to do is just stretch the wedjet and floss through the contact area and let go. Now you have your rubber dam completely secure. This means that if the patient closes, that if the patient sneezes, that if the patient, you know, moves their lip in any way that they can pull or push a rubber dam out of the operative field, this is gonna keep the rubber dam in place. This and your retentive clamp. So always think about these two ways of securing or keeping your rubber dam in place. Another thing that I wanna show you is the retraction potential of the latex rubber dam, this latex isolate black rubber dam. Remember when I showed you the model initially, the mesial margin of this first molar was completely covered by tissue. Now here I don't need to use any additional clamps because as you can see, the gingival margin is completely exposed. Now you have beautiful access to that gingival margin, beautiful clean access to the gingival margin because the rubber dam is inverted correctly subgingivally, has pushed that gingival margin more apical, and now you have clean access. There is no bleeding, there is no saliva that's gonna come through that rubber dam. This is how you should perform operative dentistry.